Today on Real Talk, what's the deal with Cooperating Commission and how do we make sense of this report from the Canadian Real Estate Association? Today we have Mr. Paul Roussel from the team. Thank you very much for coming on, Paul.
Rob.
We had a report come out from the Canadian Real Estate Association. That's why I wanted to have you on here, because you're a very analytical agent and you pay attention to all these numbers. So I'm assuming this report and this forecast is going to be floating around in some of the media. Here were some of the numbers that they're predicting. Canada-wide, they're talking about a 1% drop in the number of sales and then almost a 5% decrease in the average sale price Canada-wide. But if you look more closely at Ontario, they're looking at about a 2% actual increase in the number of sales, but about a 9% drop in the average price. So that's Ontario-wide. How does that jive with what you're seeing in the local markets, Hamilton, Burlington, and surrounding areas?
Well, funny enough, it's kind of the opposite story that we're seeing locally around Hamilton, Burlington area.
I agree with that.
Yeah. What the difference is since the quarter of last year that we've seen is about a 20% increase in the amount of sales volume. Okay, and then we're looking at about a 1% increase in sales price. And then also our inventory is quite low right now at about 1.87, and that is indicating in a seller's market right now here in the Hamilton-Burlington area.
Yeah, the stats are saying a seller's market. We're seeing many cases, more anecdotally of course, but of multiple offers going in,
yep,
and houses going for over the asking price.
Yep.
Obviously not as crazy as 2021, but you know, more similar to the beginnings of 2022 when it was crazier.
Yep, yeah, I've definitely seen some hints of that. It's very seasonal this time of year that we do see quite a bit of holding offer strategies and bidding wars that are happening. But the biggest indication right there is that the low amount of inventory. When you've got low inventory and high amount of buyers, you're creating a seller's market, and that's what we're starting to see. And it's kind of seasonal, so I think we can kind of really chalk it up to that right now.
Now, Korea, they also go further and they forecast into 2024. And what they're predicting for Ontario specifically is about a 20% increase in the number of sales.
Okay.
And then a much smaller increase in the terms of sale price. I think they're looking at something in the order of 3% in sale price increase. What do you think of that? Is it even possible to look that far into the future? And what are the factors influencing that?
It's really tough to, I don't know how they analyze those numbers or how to predict that, but there's been quite a bit of few predictions in the past that are so inaccurate and wrong. All we can kind of speak to is on the ground level and what we are seeing. We do see, we are kind of predicting about a 4% increase in value for this year for the Hamilton-Burlington area specifically. If you kind of zoom out and look at Ontario, there's going to be a lot of markets that are suffering up to double-digit declines in values for this year. For what's going to happen in 2024, I don't know how anybody can predict that, but we'll see what happens.
And even more generally, what we're seeing are all these developers. We're counting on all these housing starts to deal with the immigration coming to Canada,
yep,
and to house people. But many of those, even developers, are going under, or these housing starts just aren't happening because the market doesn't have an appetite for pre-construction,
yep,
like it did in previous years. But that hasn't had an effect on the amount of people still coming to Canada.
Yeah, it's kind of an interesting thing to see what's going to happen with how we're going to deal with this immigration that this country has forecasted for the next coming years. Hard to say.
Yeah, exactly. Now, another thing that's come up recently, Paul, is the Cooperating Commission, the commission that,
yes,
a seller is paying to the buying agent. And this can be very confusing in the marketplace for sellers because they're seeing like 2.5%, they're seeing flat rate commissions, they're seeing 3%, they're hearing agents say things like going rate commission, which I probably shouldn't even say on camera, because
nope,
we're not, there is no going rate. What is your read on that, and how can a seller make sense of this?
Really good question, really good point. So we'll first touch upon that there is no sort of standard rate that you offer,
yeah,
out to a cooperating broker, okay? This is up to, between you and your realtor to decide what's gonna work to attract essentially buyers and their agent to come see your property, okay? Typically, in the Hamilton-Burlington area, we see a cooperating commission of about 2%.
Yeah.
You will see some realtors that say you have to offer out 2.5%. Goes against RICO rules, they cannot be saying that kind of verbiage, okay? But it might actually be a suggestion that you might wanna consider, okay? Given all the facts in your local market. Now, Some agents will use that as a ploy to actually get more agents into your home by using your dollars to actually attract them to see that house.
Rather than their own marketing budget.
Rather than actually spending money on marketing that home, okay? So be very careful when an agent says, we have to offer out 2.5% to attract a buyer. Might not necessarily be true, okay?
So why would a seller ever even offer more than what they're seeing in the marketplace? What would be an incentive for that?
Well, if you have a very similar property to other ones that are in and around the area, then it might be a tactic that you could use to try and anticipate or entice other agents to come see your house and show their buyers. At the end of the day, the laws are that the agent cannot put their commission before
exactly.
their client,
yeah.
okay? So they have to do what's in their best interest of their clients at all times. We have a fiduciary duty to do that for our clients.
Yeah, so you're bringing your client to see properties at 2%, 2.5%.
$1,000 flat fee, doesn't
flat
matter.
Fee.
You have to do what your client is asking to see that property. And the commission should never come into any sort of point that makes you decide whether or not you should buy that house, okay?
Awesome, that's a great way to describe it. Well, thanks for all your great insights, Paul, and thanks for coming on.
Thanks, Peter.